Almost out. Leon.
All right, what have we got?
I never knew that.
Maybe in one of these. Just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Well, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
All this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing!
Hey, Deacon! You're too close, Tull. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid! What I can do. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Hold on, hold on. They're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
go check them out, see what they're doing. All right, gotta go in quiet.
Hear that? Civilian! I am not going to ask you again!
I don't want
to. We will shoot!
Civilian, I am not going to ask you again.
Okay, that ought to distract them.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
Of course. According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Now to Dr. Anderson. Your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
They're sleeping like babies, Sarah.
And I asked if you were going in. Say I was.
They're not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
Stay in the shrubs. They can't see me.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. Not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was FUBAR from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Seal the caves. Yeah, right, like anyone gives a damn.
Hear that?
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode out of farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
God, O'Brien. I'm gonna shut up about it. All the way out the three-finger jack.
He's alive.
The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard you. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen. I heard them on the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
Not, Boozer, I'm not. I'm just... Okay, get some sleep. Deacon out.
how's it going? I crafted you a couple of items, if you want to swing by.
Yeah, I do need some. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Who remembers the skid rows in this big country? People living on the streets in boxes and tents. Because they couldn't afford the American dream. Some of those good people fought for this very country. The feds forget about it as soon as they were done. PTSD. Doesn't stand for post-traumatic stress disorder. It stands for put them soldiers down. We're all homeless now. Living in the wilderness, the way of life. The feds used to think we'd get their welfare and handouts to survive. We showed them how wrong they were. But we got you. We want our trust in them. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's great. That's great. Radio Free Oregon's on the air once again. Oh, Jesus, what have I done?
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode on a farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Brian.
Okay, you were saying?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, loser. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait.
Listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
Not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out. Booze man, thank you, brother. I'll be by. Might be useful.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Who remembers the skid rows of this great country? People living on the streets and... and tents because they couldn't afford the American dream. Some of those good people fought for this very country, only to have the feds forget about them as soon as they were done with them. PTSD doesn't stand for post-traumatic stress disorder. It stands for put them soldiers down. Well, we're all homeless now. Living in the wilderness in the way of our forebears. The feds used to think they needed their welfare and handouts to survive. We showed them how wrong they were. What we need now is a strong will, determination, and trust in each other. The feds were never going to give us that. You want our trust? You gotta earn it. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's great! Yeah, Radio Free Oregon is on the air once again! Oh God, what have I done?
Good.
Don't worry, Alvarez. I'm not gonna leave you to the freaks.
Burning hell.
More bounties.
Learn something new every day. What do we got?
Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers.
Deer Crossing. Something's never changed. I got a use for you. Way onto the roof. Get in there. Yeah.
mind. And you're not. They're real. And they're proof. And I was right. We thought Nero died out here like the rest of them. Caving under their own stupidity. But no. Like I said, they've been lying and wait all this time till they crawl up out of their holes and reclaim this world. But it ain't happening. Not on my watch. And don't go running towards them thinking they're gonna save your ass. Any man wearing a uniform worth a damn died more than 2 years ago. These men, they'll shoot you on sight. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus. Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit. You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy. Scrap.
It's gonna bring them all down on me.
Yes, finally. All right. Now let's see what they got there.
Another micro recorder. One of these is gonna
Sir,
explain
we got a
what
problem.
The hell you guys
we got a lot of problems. What are you talking about? We got another train coming in hot.
Those people move back. Move back. Radio command, we got no more room. I told you another dozen backups out here. We're gonna shut this site
Sir,
down.
Sir, you don't understand.
Well, I know. Those assholes are important. Just don't listen to them. I tell them we got no more room.
Shit,
we got drowning back up over the fairway.
Use this.
St. John, this is Copeland. I haven't seen Boozer in a few days. He used to do runs for me, is all. I know you ride with him. Tried to radio him, can't seem to reach him. Well, you see him, you tell him to swing by and say hello to Cope. I would much appreciate it. Copeland out.
Okay.
fuel can. This.
That should do it.
Sniper on the road. Oh, goddammit.
This is radio. The truth.
Goddammit, not now!
This Earth is a gift for us all.
Yeah.
To use as we see fit. To provide for ourselves and our families. I'm not saying this. It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men. They wanted more. When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, we wanted to build dams for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We wanted to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now that the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middle lane. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Should have seen that coming.
One less ambush. It doesn't look too bad. That'll hold. Scrap. Another Nero site. I wonder if there's anything inside that mobile medical unit.
Yeah.
More bounties.
Nesting zone.
Oh, I gotta clear it out. I gotta cut down on the swarmers out here.